Hi everyone, happy May. So April went by like a nap, like it was the quickest month ever in the history of the universe. I can't even believe how quick it went by. March was the slowest month on record, so it's a little bit shocking, especially since I was home the entire month of April. It just went by in a flash, can't believe it. Okay, so the intro to this is gonna be short and sweet because I'm trying to make this video a little bit shorter. I'm trying to make this video 10 minutes. That's all you get with it for an intro today. I hope you enjoy this video. Oh yeah, by the way, this is my April favorites video. That was the worst intro ever because I didn't even say what the video is. This is my April favorites video. Enjoy. First up is a coffee mug. This is a Plant Addict life cycle? Plant Addict thought cycle mug. So it goes around with the thought cycle of someone that has too many plants and how they justify buying just one more plant. I love this mug. I love the colors of it. I think that it's really cute. I love the size. It's not too big. It's not too small. It's not heavy. It's dishwasher safe. It's microwave safe. It's just a good mug. I don't remember where it's from, but I will link it down below because I bought it not long ago, so I will easily be able to find it in my email. But it's from a store that I've never shopped at before, so I will definitely link it down below. It's really cute. If you like plants like I do, it's necessary. Next up, I'm going to talk about two natural deodorants, the Drunk Elephant one and a new scent from Mega Babe. So I'm going to talk about Drunk Elephant first. This is a deodorant cream. This is the first time I've ever used a deodorant cream in this type of packaging. I've only ever used deodorant creams in like jars or little tubs before, but this has little holes at the top and a twist up at the bottom. So that's how you dispense it. I find that personally, I like to apply this using my fingers. Like I do a little twist up and then I apply half to one underarm and half to the other. And I find that that works best for me. Just in terms of ease and mess, I just find that one little twist up is enough for both of my underarms. So, you know, using this is kind of a learning curve. So you'll figure out what amount works for you, but that's just what works for me. So it doesn't really matter in terms of your experience. But in case you were looking for ideas of how to use it, there is one. I think that the performance of this is really good. I can't give this a full review yet because I have not tested it in every circumstance. And I reviewed a natural deodorant once a while back before I tested it in every circumstance and it totally failed me and I regretted it. So you won't get a full review on this until like the end of summer probably. But so far I really, really like it. And I feel like I'm really picky because the only other deodorants I've ever found that I liked are the Mega Babe ones. The fact that this one has made a good impression is positive in my opinion, and I've really enjoyed using it. I also enjoy that it's essentially fragrance free. Like you put it on, it smells like almonds, but that goes away so quickly. I don't like smelling strongly of anything almost ever. Like I am not typically a perfume wearer or anything like that. I have really sensitive sinuses and sometimes things that work for me just shift and don't work for me. So I like having scent-free options of everything because I'm so sensitive. Next is a new scent from Mega Babe. It's their Beachy Pits. I feel like I've reviewed this before. I've talked about it in favorites before, the Mega Babe formula anyway. This is a new scent, obviously. I just said that. But Mega Babe is my go-to natural deodorant, my go-to deodorant period. It's what I wear or what I previously wore every single day before I got the Drunk Elephant one. And this is no different. I don't find that it smells like the beach. Like when I think of beachy smells, I think of SPF and coconuts and that's pretty much it. This smells like fresh and lightly floral, I think. Definitely smells really good. It's not like beach to me. It has some nostalgic something to it, but I can't pinpoint it. I can't like tell you what it is, but I really like it. I like it enough that I bought the body wash with it and I don't regret. Like I'm pleased. I really like this. Next is also from Mega Babe. I'm not going to talk a lot about this. It's their Squeaky Clean Hand Sanitizer. This smells slightly of citrus. It is in stock, so you can actually buy it. I know that some people have been having trouble finding hand sanitizer. Mega Babe has these big 16 fluid ounce bottles. I bought 4 of them because I'm going back to work soon and I'm going to need hand sanitizer at the ready. And this smells slightly citrusy. It's not overwhelming at all, but it is a lot more pleasant than just that scent of alcohol basically that unscented hand sanitizers have. So yeah, I'm a fan of this. Also, it's a gel. It's not like a liquid, which I appreciate because I just find that they're easier to use and easier to apply. Next is the Drunk Elephant Wild Marula Tangle Spray. So as I said in my initial video about the Drunk Elephant hair and body range, I don't really use this as a tangle spray because my hair really doesn't get tangly. I use this more as a leave-in treatment or a heat protectant. I've used this on wet hair and dry hair. I find that it's versatile. It doesn't weigh my hair down. My hair is very fine, and as you can see, the roots are prone to flatness. And so I really appreciate that it's not heavy. I just really like it. It applies really easily. It's really easy to use. As a heat protectant, it has that nice slip so you don't get those kinks in your hair with hot tools. I just really like it. It's probably my favorite product from the new line. It's probably this and the deodorant kind of tied, with the body lotion lagging slightly behind. Speaking of the body lotion, I finished it, so it has to go in the favorites. Like, you don't finish something if you don't love it, or at least I don't. I know, it's my toxic trait. I don't finish things unless I really like them. But I loved this. I loved it so much. It's like light to medium body, but it absorbs so quickly, and it's very hydrating. I have really, really dry body skin most of the time. Like, I thought that once seasons transitioned, I kind of like evened out, but so far this year I haven't. So I don't know if that's just because our weather is whack, or if because I'm getting older and just drier as I get older. But this keeps me comfortable. It's not scented. It smells like almonds when you put it on, as does everything in this line. And I'm sure I've said that already in this video. I'm sorry, but it goes away, and I appreciate that. I love it. I love the packaging. I think it's really cute, and yeah, I definitely need a new one of these. Next is the Ilia Super Serum Skin Tint. This is a shocking favorite to me because I honestly can't believe that I like it as much as I do. I am a medium coverage person, or full coverage. I don't discriminate. I like having coverage because I have acne, I have scarring, I have hyperpigmentation, all that stuff. So I like having coverage, and this does not have coverage. It does, but it's like the slightest bit. It's basically like a BB cream or something like that, except for it's more of a serum, like oil texture almost. It's so good though. It gives the most radiant finish. It is easy to layer a concealer over top of it. So that's what I do. I just spot conceal after I apply it. It works well with a brush, works well with a sponge. It applies really nicely. I find that it doesn't layer well with itself, so you can only apply one layer of it. Just be forewarned. If you apply more layers, it kind of patches up and doesn't look as nice. So I just do one layer and then I spot conceal, and I really, really like it. Plus the packaging is just really cute. I love little dropper bottles. I just think that they're adorable. And this does have SPF 40. I always layer another SPF underneath, just because I find that to get the actual adequate coverage with an SPF in a base product, you have to use so much of it that it's just unrealistic. So I just apply a separate SPF underneath to be safe. And that's all I'm gonna say about it. Next is the Glossier Hand Cream. I feel like there is a little bit of a split on whether or not people like this, but I really like it. I love the packaging. It doesn't smell like you to me at all, almost. It smells very earthy, musky, maybe with like an essence of you. It's not heavy, it's not greasy. The only thing I will say is that it is definitely scented. So like I said, I don't wear scented products all that often. This is something that doesn't irritate my sinuses. Glossier scents don't irritate my sinuses, which is amazing. I love you. That is why I bought this, actually, because that is one of the only perfumes that I can use reliably without having any type of reaction to it. So that's why I bought this, and I really like it. I like the way it feels on the skin, but I won't be wearing it to like work or anything like that, just because I'm very conscious of other people's perception of scents, and I know that most people do not want to be subjected to other people's clouds of aroma, myself included. I really don't like it when clients come in wearing fragrance that is overwhelming, because it usually gives me a headache, and I hate that. So I just try to be sensitive to other people. I really like this though. Next is the Bare Minerals Original Foundation. So this is a throwback. I used this. This was the first foundation I ever used, actually. This was the foundation I wore all through high school, and the reason is because it's my mom's foundation of choice. She's worn Bare Minerals since they came out. Like, she's been an avid Bare Minerals lover for years and years and years. So it was my first foundation, and once I was able to drive and, you know, go to Sephora and whatever, I kind of broke away from it, and I just never revisited it until this past month. And it is so good. I understand why it has such good reviews on Sephora now. It is a powder foundation, but it has great coverage somehow. I don't understand how. It is, like, it's matte, but it's also luminous. I don't know how that works. It's just really, really good. It's no fuss. It's easy. It's so easy to apply, so easy to use, so easy to wear, and it looks so good. It makes my skin look so good. I can't even believe it. Like, it just blows my mind. It's held up over the years. This is the nail polish from Nails Inc. in the shade Duke Street. I don't know. I think this is just a regular old cream nail polish. I love Nails Inc. formula. I only have 4 or 5 of their polishes, but it's such a nice formula. They dry pretty quickly. They cure pretty quickly. They look really nice. They stay shiny for quite a while, even without a top coat, which I'm sometimes bad and forget to apply a top coat. Sorry, but I really like these. Plus the packaging is really beautiful. It's weighty, it's nice. It obviously has the removable metal cap because it would be difficult to apply nail polish with that. But I especially love this color. I just love these formulas. They're just really, really nice, easy to use, easy to apply. Next is Supergoop's Glow Screen, which is SPF 40. I have been loving this as a luminous primer. I don't think that this would be great if you don't wear makeup, because it is very, very, very radiant. It is a beautiful primer. Makeup layers over it so beautifully. It just gives you a radiance. It's so pretty. I just can't even stand it. And yes, when you apply it at first, you do look very sparkly. But applying foundation or skin tint or a BB cream or whatever over top of it really calms that down, in my opinion. Next is the Tarte Jelly Glaze. I love this. I'm so sad that I didn't pick up another scent or another tint during the Sephora sale. I just completely forgot. I don't know how I forgot, because I've been using this almost every day. I got the shade or the scent Toasted Coconut, and it does smell like coconut, and it is delicious and it's beautiful, and I'm just obsessed with it. It's like a vacation for your senses. This is definitely scented. It does not bother my head, but it is scented. It's not overwhelming. Like, I don't think anyone anywhere near me could smell it, but I can smell it because it's right under my nose. But I really love this. It's so comfortable. I like applying it as my last step when I'm doing my makeup in the morning, just because I find that it reinvigorates my lips and it gives me comfort for quite a while, as opposed to just like a normal lip balm. I love it. I want the grapefruit one. I think that's what it's called. Okay, I'm cutting myself off. If you have any questions about anything, please leave them down below. I'm sorry this video was probably a little bit longer than 10 minutes. I tried really hard. But yeah, I just am too long-winded always. Thank you so much for watching. I will talk to you all later. Bye.